Who had 5 hits in his first major league game? Folks, we're in a Sunday showdown. We got coffee and trivia. Adam's trailing, and we got to make up some ground here. Well, at least Adam does. I don't. But what do we got?
What do we got? So we have a player or players mm-hmm. who had 5 hits in his first major league game. So at least one of these answers correct, but possibly more. So we have Fred Clarke, Roy McMillan, Daniel Nava, Bobby Richardson, or Cecil Travis. Mm.
Boy. I don't know. I'm going to go with Richardson.
Okay. I'm going with Fred Clarke. Don't know why, but it sticks out to me. I remember Daniel Nava, didn't he hit like a grand slam in his first at bat?
He did something. He may have gone 5 hits. I don't know. He had a great start to his season, to his career. But
okay, 5 hits in his first major league game. We have who'd you guess?
Richardson.
Okay, our correct answer is Cecil Travis and mm-hmm. Fred Clarke.
Oh, Adam, big,
huge. Okay.
I thought I feel like I wanted to go Cecil Travis and I didn't.
All right, so little Cecil Travis here, 1933 was his date, May 16, 1933. Mm-hmm. 5 singles, scored 3 runs as his Senators beat Cleveland 11-10 in 12 innings.
Okay.
Wow, the Senators had 27 hits that day.
That's a lot of hits.
Fred Clarke debuted June 30th, 1894 for the Louisville Colonels. Had 4 singles and a triple and went on to a Hall of Fame career as a player manager with the Colonels and later the Pirates.
Yeah. He had this is kind of Fred. Had a 21-year career. 312
as a player,
312 career batter. Well,
he had a 21 year career as a player or
over. Well, so 1894 he played.
Oh, he was a player manager, right?
He was, but he only played in like between 1913 and 1915, he only played in 12 games. So he was effectively done as a player in 1911.
Mm-hmm.
You know, 17, 18 years.
Okay.
312 career batter, 67 home runs, 2,678 hits.
All right. Well, fun times with Fred Clarke there. We got to move ourselves along to the 8th inning here.
We do.
Folks. And here we go. Here's our 8th inning Red Sox question coming your way.
Mm-hmm.
What Boston player has the highest batting average in a season after Ted Williams? I mean, this is an easy one because Ted Williams, but we have Wade Boggs, Nomar Garciaparra, or Tris Speaker.
Single season batting average?
Yes.
I thought Tris was before Ted. Maybe I don't know. I'm going to go Wade Boggs.
What? What do you mean before?
Oh, wait. Other than Ted Williams. I thought it meant like after Ted Williams played.
Oh, no.
No, okay.
Yeah. If we're like ranking and Ted Williams is number 1.
Yeah. Tris. Oh, man. Tris. I'm going to still go Wade.
Okay. I'm going to go. Man, Garciaparra had a year where he went bonkers. But Tris Speaker at a time when some of those guys had. I'm going to go Tris Speaker on this one. You're going Boggs. I'm going Speaker. Let's see what we get. The correct answer. So, of course, Ted Williams is first on the list. 406, 1941. Although I've been reading recently, have you seen this stat about how they counted sacrifice flies as at bats back then.
Interesting. Oh, okay.
And so he, using modern scoring, he would have hit 419. Yeah. Okay. So our second place after that, hitting 383 in 1912.
Tris Speaker.
Tris,
bro. Nice.
You know what that means?
You're cutting into it. That's what it means.
Sure am. It's a one-run game heading into the ninth. This is huge.
It's a one-run game? What?
Yeah.
I thought I had more cushion than that to work with.
You sure did not.
Sure did not. Boggs. What did Boggs hit?
Oh, he hit 372. No, 368.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Garcia Parra went crazy. 372 in 2000.
Well, that's pretty good.
Yeah. So how about that? Well, folks, whew, we got ourselves a game. We're heading to the ninth inning, which means we're sticking with it's November. We just not too far removed from the World Series, so we're sticking with some World Series trivia.
Mm-hmm.
Aaron, turn that brain on. Here you go.
So it's 5-4? Because this changes my strategy.
It is 5-4.
Okay, let's change my strategy.
Yeah. Okay, here's your first question.
Mm-hmm.
Who hit the first... Did we do this one? Who hit the first Grand Slam in World Series history? Did we do that one?
I feel like maybe.
Okay. Well, one of these answers. One of the answers is Bill Walmsgans, and I feel like we had him as.
Walmsgans was the triple play guy.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, here we go. Who hit the first Grand Slam in World Series history? Mm-hmm. Jimmy Sebring, Jim Bagby, Bill Walmsgans, or Elmer Smith?
I'm going to go with Bagby. I feel like I heard this once upon a time.
Jim Bagby, incorrect.
Dang it. You're going to come back on me.
I'm going to guess Sebring on this one. Would have been incorrect. It's Elmer Smith, Game 5 of the 1920 series. It says Elmer Smith hit a grand slam and Jim Bagby also homered as the Indians took the lead in games 3-2. That doesn't make sense, but that's okay. You know, not every piece of writing makes sense.
Are you kidding? There's two different guys named Jim Bagby.
Oh, yeah? Did they play at the same time?
They did not.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, you got a gooser.
Gooser.
Okay, right. Here we go. Bottom of the ninth after a massive comeback here. Okay. Not going to do that one. Okay, here we go. The way this one's phrased is tough. It's phrased, who scored the first RBI in World Series history?
Okay.
I'm going to guess that's who hit the first RBI.
Yeah.
Not scored the first run. So we have Cy Young, Tommy Leach, Honus Wagner, or Fred Clarke.
Our boy.
I have no idea, but Fred Clarke did me well the first time around. So why not go Fred Clarke again?
Why not jump on the Fred Clarke bandwagon?
Why not? Well, because that's the incorrect answer is why you wouldn't do that.
Honus?
It is Wagner. Hit a single in the top of the first of the 1903 series, scoring Tommy Leach. There's a trivia question. Who scored the first run in World Series history for the Pirates? So there we go. Bottom of the ninth. Shut me down.
Look at that, though. I mean, we had a blowout in the crosshairs with a shutout on the horizon, and you absolutely took a test.
I came back. So, Aaron, as you do, it's story time. What do you got for us today?
Boy, I don't know. So one of the things that has been fun has been baseball, like just cards, opening packs, and just having fun with it. And I've also been doing like little, so on Twitter, I have a Twitter account, but pretty much the most of what I do on that, I don't do a whole lot. I like interacting on stuff. A lot of people do giveaways. And so I've been doing giveaways, and it's been fun. I've won like six of them. So
wow.
So my collection of those has been, the first one that I won was a Mark McGwire Topps 87 and a starting lineup to go with. Yeah, it was huge. And then I've got like, I got my first Julio card through a giveaway. It's a money card. I'll have to get it sometime and show put on here. I got a series of like, I got an A-Rod, a Buhner, couple cards, and then I got a box of cards coming in the mail. And then I recently won a basketball card that's going to go to Adam's son, who's collecting basketball cards. So anyway, I just thought, I don't know why, I just want to share that, but it's been fun, like collecting these, doing these little giveaways, and getting these fun little things. So
yeah, well, card collecting and all that is a fun part of our show too. I mean, Mint Condition Monday, every Monday, coming up again tomorrow. We're ripping a new pack. In fact, I got it here with me right here. Little sneak peek for you. Boop, Fleer 97.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a fun little pack that we're going to have a good time ripping tomorrow. But Aaron, thanks for sharing got some spoils.
The giveaway drink. It's been fun. Very fun. Yeah. So,
you know what else is fun? Doing this every day with y'all folks.
Yeah.
The season's over, but not for us. We're still here every day. You need your baseball fix right here all day.
We got
not
it
all day, but once a day, every day.
Yeah, we're like vitamin T. T for trivia. Vitamin yeah. T. So anyway, thanks folks for hanging with us. We'll see you tomorrow.